Hey folks, this is Sebastian, and as you've probably just seen, this video is a short description of how to measure the height from which you drop a ball using the microphone in your smartphone. So the principle is the same as in my videos on measuring the speed of sound or measuring the time for a free fall. If you missed those, check out the video description. But as I said, the principle is the same. The smartphone just listens for the sound of the bouncing ball. So let's discuss how this works.
You will need a smartphone with FreeFox, which you can get for free on Android and iOS from freefox.org. In FreeFox, we select the experiment Inelastic Collision. This experiment has the same settings as the acoustic stopwatch. Pick a threshold that is high enough so that the measurement is not triggered by environment noise, but low enough so that it is triggered by each bounce of the ball. The minimum delay can usually be left at its default, but you can increase it if a single bounce triggers the measurement twice. Just make sure that it remains shorter than the shortest bounce interval. All you need besides your phone with FreeFox is a ball that bounces well and produces a loud sound on each bounce, like a basketball. If we drop it from 2 meters, the app picks up the sound from the bounces and gives us a close estimate of the drop height. So, how does it work? We need the timing of 3 bounces. If we neglect air drag, we can assume a free fall in between each bounce. From this, we can calculate the maximum height between each bounce. Now that we have 2 heights, we can use their ratio to determine how much energy is lost on each bounce. The potential energy before and after a bounce only changes because of a different maximum height. If we now assume that the same ratio of energy is also lost on the first bounce, we can estimate the initial height. You might notice that for most balls you lose a bit more energy for fast impacts and keep more energy on the slower bounces from smaller heights. So we often slightly underestimate the initial height because in reality there was a bit more energy at the beginning that was lost on the first bounce.
I really like this experiment because it's so simple to show. I often have a metal ball on me to demonstrate it the way you just seen it at the beginning of this video, so if anybody asks me what FreeFox is and what I do, I can simply show them. I hope you enjoyed it as well. If you want to learn about more smartphone experiments, check out freefox.org, and I hope to see you around the next time.